Yeah, so on our last record, Viva La Vida, we started working with Marcus Dravs and Brian Eno, as well as Rick and Dan, these two guys we were always with. And so we kind of had a new team on the last one, and we built a little place called The Bakery. And when we finished Viva La Vida, we were immediately summoned back into the studio by Brian Eno because he felt we could keep pushing a bit further into unknown territory. And so it sort of just rolled in amongst all the touring of the last album. We've just been in the studio a lot. Brian Eno's become more of a sort of, not a session musician, but a player. He loves to just stand in the circle and play with the band. So he's kind of more a band member than a producer this time, which is very fun because he comes up with very strange ideas and crazy noises, and they always eventually sound, irreplaceable. The key bits of advice Brian's given to us are really to do with self-confidence and not being afraid to really reflect what we love and what we listen to, and not be so concerned about where we might fit in the sort of overall scheme of bands, and just to try and be a bit more fearless, because I think as Englishmen and as musicians 50 years into rock music, we can get a bit intimidated by, well, we had this song called Princess of China about 2 years ago that I always was secretly wanting to give to, well, offer to Rihanna to sing, but I really liked singing the first verse, so. And then the sweep of the album sort of came together, and this song really fit as a sort of damaged love song. And so, after about 6 months of not feeling brave enough to, we got in contact with her and asked if she'd sing on it. And fortunately for us, she said yes. And it's by far and away the best bit of singing on the album. We have no plans at the moment past Thursday. It's a day at a time. You can't take anything for granted anymore. It doesn't matter if you used to be big or you used to be famous, or you've got to prove yourself all over again. So we don't have any immediate touring plans. We've just got to see if anyone is interested in listening to an album with that group of people. And we're very fired up and we're very focused, and the people that want to enjoy our music, we love them and we welcome them. But in terms of where we fit in, I don't care.